Good morning, everyone. Today I'm going to be doing a what I eat in a day video. This is a long time coming because a lot of people ask me about this. For someone who follows a gluten and dairy free diet, I'm going to bring you along and show you what I eat in a day. Also, being postmenopausal and having my 57th birthday next week, I'm going to show you some of the estrogen-rich foods that I incorporate into my daily routine. So, with that being said, let's get to it. Welcome back. I'm Deborah, that's me, where I share simple things in my island life on the east coast of Canada. I normally start each day with a decaf coffee. I will take my cleaver, which you see here, and the filters, and put it inside, and then I will add a heaping spoon of my favorite decaf coffee. Once the kettle comes to a boil, I will add the water and let the coffee steep for 4 or 5 minutes until nice and aromatic and flavorful. I also have an Amazon storefront, so I'll be sure to link anything in this video that you may like to try yourself in the description box down below. So next, I will take my coffee mug, my favorite plant-based milk or plant-based coffee creamer, as well as a scoopful of California Gold collagen powder. I will heat this up and then make it all nice and mixed with my frother. Now, for the taste test. Delish. If I decide I want a little bit more sweetness in my coffee in the morning, I will add a little bit of coconut sugar or a non-dairy coffee creamer. I will also be sure to link the collagen powder that I use in the description box down below. Now, I'm gonna go get ready and let's make some breakfast. Each morning, I try to start off with a bowl of gluten-free oatmeal. It is really important, especially being on a gluten-free diet, as with all of the starch and rice that a lot of gluten-free foods happen to be made of, will tend to cause one to be constipated. So fiber's key in your diet anyway, but it's definitely really important if you're on a gluten-free diet to incorporate fiber into it. So I normally like to start my day with fiber. I have half a cup of gluten-free oatmeal, a half a cup of a plant-based milk, some salt, a half a tablespoon of flax meal, as well as a couple of tablespoons of maple syrup. I microwave for 2 minutes and then voila, it will be all ready. Let stand and cool for about 5 minutes so that you don't burn your mouth. But this is how I like to start every morning. Oats and flax meal are two estrogen-rich foods that I incorporate into my daily routine. Here I'm making myself some lemon water, where I will just get some bottled water, add some ice cubes, and a few slices of lemon. I normally refill this over and over throughout the day to ensure that I'm getting my intake of water. And lemons are another source of an estrogen-rich food. couple hours after having my oatmeal, I will then have a lunch brunch. Today I'm going to be making a skillet meal. I'm going to be doing some frozen vegetables and spinach and making a vegetable medley. I'm then also going to fry a couple of eggs and add a slice of gluten-free toast with a vegan margarine and some raspberry jam. The estrogen-rich foods in this meal are spinach and the minced garlic. My favorite gluten-free bread, as seen here, is the Promise bread, which is free of almost every allergen you could think of. This is definitely my favorite toast and sandwich bread. One thing I have found being gluten and dairy free is the importance of meal prep. Trying to set aside some kind of recipes or what I would like to eat for the week, ensuring that I buy all the groceries and the ingredients and having them in the fridge. When following this kind of a diet, it's really important not to get sidetracked or end up getting something on the fly that will end up making you sick and that you will seriously regret, because we all know that the side effects of getting into allergens or intolerances can be devastating. Migraines, fatigue, lack of sleep, digestive issues, all of the things that you want to avoid when you're following a gluten and dairy-free diet. So here is my lunch. A nice skillet vegetable medley, a slice of gluten-free toast, and two fried eggs. And don't forget the ketchup. I don't know if you experience this, but having a kind of mid-afternoon slump where you just need a little bit of a pick-me-up. So here I'm going to be refreshing my lemon water, as well as having a little snack, some peanuts in the shell, as well as a little sweet treat, some donuts I made in a previous video. I will be sure to link that up above or at the end of this video. Some cakebox recipes that turned out fabulous. This final meal I'm making in my what I eat in a day, I have actually never had before. Some potato gnocchi. When I was at my local Sobeys and saw that they carry this potato gnocchi, I was like, I have got to try this. And when you're doing your meal prep, you know, it's okay to have some things that are ready to serve, because it is really tasking to always have to make everything that you want to eat. One thing about being gluten and dairy free, there's not a lot of eating out, and there's not a lot of just having fast food, ordering pizza. It's just not a thing. Which, you know, can be incredibly isolating. And I don't know if you're like me, but sometimes you feel like that friend, you know, the one that everybody has to accommodate whenever you want to go out and eat or get together. So that can leave one feeling incredibly lonesome and just deciding not to go because you don't want to inconvenience anyone. So if you're out there and you're feeling like that, I'm with you, and I don't really know of a really good solution other than maybe just packing yourself a goodie bag and going out with your friends. They will eventually get used to it and hopefully not be embarrassed by the fact that you need to do this for you to ensure that you're healthy and that you don't get sick. So I'm making, with this potato gnocchi, a really nice coconut tomato sauce. I'm adding some red onion, red pepper, celery, mushrooms, garlic. This is such a beautiful, colorful, delicious sauce. I'd also decided that I was going to puree all of these vegetables and make this so that it wasn't really like chunky or heavy. Sometimes, you know, you just, absence makes the heart grow fonder, or out of sight, out of mind. Whereas if you don't see it, you don't necessarily realize all the deliciousness that you're having, especially if you're kind of preparing for kids or grandkids or other people that aren't fond of vegetables. It allows you to incorporate it into your meal kind of without even really knowing. If you're enjoying my content or any of my videos, please be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe, as it really helps the YouTube algorithm. It helps attract like-minded individuals like yourself and help grow my community. Now, if you make potato gnocchi at home, please let me know how you put it together. What do you pair it with? Let me know in the comments down below. As this is my first time having it, do you make it from scratch? Do you have a good recipe making it from scratch? Please let me know. I would love to hear from you. I also have no idea if I am pronouncing it correctly. So hopefully, potato gnocchi? 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 I'm pretty sure it's gnocchi. Anyway, maybe you can also clarify that for me as well in the comments down below. Love to hear from you. So here I've added in a few spices, some salt, pepper, fresh garlic, just, you know, to spruce things up a little. So here I am kind of putting the final touches on our tomato coconut kind of rosé sauce, adding our coconut milk, our tomato sauce, sautéing our vegetables, mixing it all together. I also decided to add a tablespoon of a coconut sugar. Most of you probably already know this, but if you're ever having acidic foods like a tomato-based sauce, if you add a tablespoon of sugar, brown sugar, coconut sugar, it will help reduce the acid or any kind of reflux you may experience when eating these types of foods. The instructions for cooking this potato gnocchi is to bring salted water to a boil, add your serving into the pot, and when the gnocchi floats to the top, you let boil for 2 minutes. And then remove from the water onto your plate, as seen here. Then we're going to top with our delicious homemade rosé vegetable sauce. I also decided to pair a salad with this. So I take a couple of different kinds of leafy green lettuces and dice them all up, put them in a bowl. I also add some green onion. And if you ever happen to be looking for a really simple, easy salad dressing, I usually just top my salad with some mayonnaise and a little bit of pepper. Super simple, something we almost all have in the refrigerator, easy to use. So there you have it, everyone. My first what I eat in a day, being gluten and dairy free, and a postmenopausal woman trying to incorporate estrogen-rich foods into my diet. I will be sure to list all of the estrogen-rich foods that I consume today in the description box down below so that you can see if you happen to want to try this. But yeah, thanks for hanging out, everyone, and let me know in the description box down below if you'd like to see another What I Eat in a Day. Thanks, everyone. Bye-bye.